I'm Anne from the National Air and Space Museum, and I'm here to bring some of our museum stories to you at home. Can you imagine going outside of a spaceship or space station to float in space? What do you think that would feel like? When astronauts go outside, they call that a spacewalk, even though they don't really walk at all. To go outside in space, you need special protection because space is very dangerous for people. There's no air to breathe, the sun's light is very strong, and it could be really hot or really cold, and there's no ground to stand on. A spacesuit is very special. It's made of very strong material that won't rip or tear. The reason it's white in color is so that the strong rays of the sun will reflect or bounce off of it. The suit has a giant human-sized balloon inside that keeps the air in. It has communication equipment and all kinds of controls for the astronaut. It's almost like a suit of armor or a personal spaceship that keeps the astronaut alive. Astronauts on the International Space Station often put on their white suits to go outside of the space station to do repairs or add equipment. Here's a photo of astronauts Victor Glover and Kate Rubins on a spacewalk with their suits on. In this picture, you can see the Earth behind them. The astronauts are holding onto gold-colored handles so they won't float away. They're also attached to the spaceship with strong metal cables. Their teammate Soichi Noguchi helped them get ready to go outside and check to make sure everything was safe. The astronauts take turns being the ones who go outside and the ones who stay in to support the spacewalkers. Then the two astronauts who went outside to work on a truss that would later support new solar panels. The solar panels collect energy from the sun that provides all the power for all the machines and equipment on the station. Some of the things that need power are science experiments like growing plants in space. The power also supplies light, water, food, and all of the other things that the astronauts need to survive and live. It must be very exciting to be the astronaut who goes outside of the space station. Here's a story about that. Once upon a time, there were three friends who liked tools, building things, and space. They were Millie, Ruth, and Lou. One day, the three friends were out on their scooters and they rode past Sebastian's house. Sebastian came out with a toy helicopter that was all in pieces and three small battery-operated screwdrivers. "Would you like these? The tools still work, but they need new batteries. I have a new screwdriver that's bigger, but these would be just the right size for you." "Yes," said Lou. "Thanks," said Millie. "See you later," said Ruth. "See ya," said Sebastian. "Glad you could use them." They took the toys and tools to Millie's house, and she found some new batteries for the screwdrivers. Lou picked up the pieces for the helicopter toy. Ruth took a pair of glasses out of her pocket and put them on. "I like your glasses," said Millie. "Thanks," said Ruth. "They help me see small things up close. Sometimes things can be a little blurry for me without them." Ruth looked closely at a shiny rectangle. "What's this part?" "Oh, that's a solar panel. You can put them in the sun and they store up energy that makes the helicopter work," Millie said. "They use solar panels like that for the rovers on Mars and for the International Space Station." They put the solar panel in a sunbeam. Then they used the screwdrivers and screws to put the helicopter together. At last, they attached the solar panel. "Does it work?" asked Ruth. Lou turned it on and the rotor spun around. It flew up. The three friends jumped up and down with excitement. The next day, at their tea party, Lou said, "Imagine if you were the astronaut putting a solar panel on the International Space Station." "Remember when we watched it fly by?" said Millie. "It would be so exciting to be floating out in space," said Lou. "And a little scary, but it would be okay if I had my team with me," said Ruth. Millie said, "Let's take new solar panels to the International Space Station." Ruth said, "I have some shiny bubble wrap that would make good solar panels." Lou said, "Let's meet back this afternoon for the trip." The three friends got their spacesuits and their rocket. They climbed inside with the solar panels, their screwdriver and screws, and a long rope. And Ruth brought some space snacks. Just then, Mo dropped by with some bungee cords with hooks on the ends. "Can you use these?" he asked. Millie said, "Yes, and why don't you come along with us to the International Space Station?" Mo grinned and climbed in the rocket. All together, they started the countdown. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, liftoff! They flew past the clouds and out into space. They docked the ship at the ISS and climbed inside. They took off their helmets and Ruth brought out some freeze-dried strawberries and squeezy yogurt. Lou said, "Okay, time to suit up for our spacewalk and install those solar panels." She put on her helmet, picked up her screwdriver, put some screws in her pocket, and grabbed a solar panel. Millie said, "We're going to need the rope so we'll all stay safe and get back to the ship. And you can hook onto the rope with the bungee cords. I'll stay behind and pull you back in." They each attached a hook onto the loop on their suit and attached the other end to the rope. Then they tied the rope to the station. "All set," said Mo. They left the space station one by one and started to float out. "Wow, it's beautiful out here," said Ruth. Lou said, "This is the place where we attach it." She held up the solar panel and placed it on the side of the station. Mo and Ruth got out their screwdrivers and started using screws to attach it. "We're going to need lots of screws to hold it in place," called Millie, who was on the ship munching on some strawberries that she floated into her mouth. "Oh no," said Ruth as she dropped her screws. They all floated out to space. "Don't worry, I've got some," said Mo. He floated to Ruth and carefully handed her a screw. Lou said, "Will it hold up?" Ruth said, "One more, I think," and she put in another screw. "Okay, let go." Lou let go and the panel stayed on. "Great job, everyone," said Lou. "Space high five," said Ruth, and they did a slow motion high five. "Now you all have to get back to the ship. We don't want to run out of oxygen. I'll pull you in," said Millie. Mo headed back first and grabbed the rope. He joined Millie and pulled Lou back. Lou helped pull Ruth back in. "We did it," said Millie. "Great teamwork. Let's head home," said Ruth. Lou said, "Spacewalks sure are hard work. I'm hungry." They got back in their rocket and headed home for dinner. It's craft time. Today we're gonna make some space snacks and we're going to make peanut butter and jelly sandwiches on tortillas. So you need some tortilla, you need peanut butter and jelly, a knife, and you're going to also need a star-shaped cookie cutter. On the International Space Station, everything floats, and so they can't use bread because the crumbs from the bread would float around and get into their equipment. So instead, they use tortillas, which don't have a lot of crumbs, or any crumbs, really. So a tortilla is a great sandwich bread to use for space. What we're gonna do is take our tortillas, and we're just gonna spread some peanut butter on the tortilla with a knife. There we go. And put some peanut butter on your tortilla. If you don't eat peanut butter, you could do this with some refried beans and make a little refried bean sandwich. And that's also a tasty sandwich to have on a tortilla. Here's some jelly. I'm using some strawberry jelly for my sandwich. You can use whatever kind of jelly you like. Anything that's sticky works really well in space too, so it doesn't float around too much. It sticks right on to the sandwich. So peanut butter and jelly is great for space food. Then put another tortilla on top and you can just eat that just like this, which is tasty. But something really fun is to take a star-shaped cookie cutter and cut out some star shapes. So then your little sandwiches are space themed. So I have little star sandwich here and I have a different star shaped cookie cutter and I made this one. Let's see. Oh, that's really fun. And now I'm gonna eat my sandwich. Really tasty. Well, thanks for joining us. See you next time. Bye-bye.